An internal control is, it's a type of control that occurs within every like biological sample that you have. You know, you might have one group of samples that you designate a control group, and you have another group of samples that you designate a treatment group, but independent of those two categorizations, there's also some quality of them that you're keeping track of across all of the samples that you have an expected result for. That to me is an internal control. So one example of an internal control actually is used quite frequently when you're looking at things like gene expression. So let's say you have some new drug treatment that you're examining, and you have two sets of samples. One you give the drug treatment, and one you give a placebo, so something that should not have any effect. And you want to see what the effect of this drug is on expression of some interesting gene that you really care about. So in one set of samples, you might expect the gene to come on. The other set of samples, you expect the gene to not turn on. But across all of the samples, you should also have certain housekeeping genes, so to say, that you're also keeping track of. So regardless of what the drug treatment is, you have a set of genes that you keep track of in all the samples where you expect to have pretty consistent levels of expression. That's a type of internal control. So the nice thing about the AR sandwich is that it has a couple different internal controls. So within each biological sample for each seedling, there are specific observations that I'm expecting to occur in each seedling. From my own research, looking at the AR sandwich, every sample has an internal negative control. So between the two blocks of agar media, there's that air gap in between. And we knew from previous observations that exposure to air should have no inductive effect on root branch production. So the fact that there's a lack of induction indicates that that is a negative control. Within my experiment with the agar sandwich, within every sample, you always have the root in contact with unaltered regular standard media, and that should induce root branching. So that's a type of positive control to show that the root is capable of producing branches at all.